I love this.
Hitting the relay in 3, 2, 1.
Awesome.
Thrusters, check. Navigation, check. Internal emission sync engaged. All systems online. Drift, just under 1,500K.
Seth Green, check.
1,500 is good. Your captain will be pleased.
I hate that guy.
Nihlus gave you a compliment. So you hate him.
You remember to zip up your jumpsuit on the way out of the bathroom? That's good. I just jumped us halfway across the galaxy and hit a target the size of a pinhead. So that's incredible. Besides, Spectres are trouble. I don't like having them on board. Call me paranoid.
You're paranoid. The Council helped fund this project. They have a right to send someone to keep an eye on their investment.
Yeah, that is the official story. But only an idiot believes the official story.
Welcome to the Wheel of Response. You're overreacting.
You always expect the worst.
Well, dialogue wheel.
Are an occupational hazard. But we don't go anywhere unless there's a good reason, so what are we doing here?
Joker, status report.
Just cleared the mass relay, Captain. Stealth systems engaged. Everything looks solid.
Good. Find a comm buoy and link us into the network. I want mission reports relayed back to Alliance Brass before we reach Eden Prime.
Aye, aye, Captain. Better brace yourself, sir. I think Nihlus is headed your way.
He's already here, Lieutenant.
Oops.
Tell Commander Shepard to meet me in the comm room for a debriefing.
Heard it.
You get that, Commander?
Yeah, you made him mad. That's what I heard.
Great. You pissed the captain off and now I'm gonna pay for it.
Ah, hit that nose.
Don't blame me. The captain's always in a bad mood.
Only when he's talking to you, Joker.
Proceed to activate the codex. Codex? Codex, right? So I got tutorials, we got personal history. Just read this really quick. I read all the things, you know me. Born into a naval family, you spent your childhood on ships and stations. You moved from posting to posting as your parents were reassigned. You enlisted in the Alliance military yourself on the day you turned 18. You were on shore leave at Elysium when the first wave of the Skillian Blitz struck. A massive coalition force of slavers, crime syndicates, and Batarian warlords attacked the human colony. Batarian warlords. To remember them. You rallied the civilian inhabitants, leading them in their desperate fight to hold off the invaders. When enemy troops broke through the colony's defenses, you single-handedly held them off and sealed that breach. After years of brutal fighting, reinforcement... After hours of brutal fighting... Yeah, kind of a lot of fighting, man. It was exhausting for years. Reinforcements finally arrived and the enemy broke ranks and fled. Because of your actions, Elysium was saved and you were regarded throughout the Alliance as a hero. Now, this thing is going to be populated, as I understand it, as we go on and meet things and people. This is pretty important to know. Bear with me here. The timeline. This is how everything went. The history of humankind, right? 2069, Armstrong Outpost at Shackleton Crater becomes the first human settlement on Luna, the moon. It is formally founded on July 24th, the 100th anniversary of the first lunar landing. Oh, very good. Alright, so we have that to look forward to. I'll be very old, but I might still be alive. 2103, Lowell City in Eos Chasma becomes the first human settlement on Mars. 2137, Eldfell Ashland Energy Corporation demonstrates helium-3 fuel extraction from the atmosphere of Saturn. So we got helium fuel from Saturn. Can you let? So, and we're settled on Mars. Construction of 2142, construction of Gagarin Station, Jump Zero, begins beyond the orbit of Pluto. 2148, prospectors discover the Prothean ruins at Promethei Planum on Mars. 2149, translation of Prothean data leads humans to the Charon Mass Relay. Systems Alliance founded to coordinate exploration and colonization of extrasolar worlds. So that's what we saw where we jump through on the in the starship, which is very reminds. I know it's a different technology. This it does remind me of Babylon 5, and I am a big Babylon 5 fan, as well as you know, Star Trek, as well. Not so much Star Wars, although I can appreciate the lore and the characters there and the story. But yeah, so I'm gonna be making references, Babylon 5 and probably Next Generation, stuff like that. So really into that stuff. 2151. A shipping accident at Singapore International Spaceport exposes downwind communities to containers of dust form element zero. Alliance begins construction of Arcturus Station. What is element zero? 2152. Roughly 30% of the children born in Singapore after element zero exposure suffer from cancerous growths. Ugh. System Alliance begins settlement of Earth's first solar extrasolar colony world, the planet Demeter. 2154, Commander Shepard born. Yay! 2155, Systems Alliance occupies completed portions of Arcturus Station as a headquarters. 2156, some children of Singapore exhibit minor telekinetic abilities. Oh, from this element zero. So I guess they're the ones without the cancerous growths? Well, not necessarily, right? 2157, Turians encounter human explorers. First contact war. Occupation and liberation of the human colony of Shanxi. 2158, humans learn potential of biotics. An international effort to track element zero exposures begins. Roughly 10% of exposed children show some level of biotic ability. So we're on to this thing here. 2156, yeah, but 4 years later, right? Things are happening quickly here. 2157, Turians encounter human explorers, first contact war. Oh, I read that. Sorry. 2160, Systems Alliance Parliament formed. 2165, humans establish embassy on Citadel. 2170, Batarian slavers attack the Alliance colony of Mindwar. That's our backstory. Skillian Blitz. Pirates and slavers attacked Elysium, the human capital in the Skillian Verge. 2177, Thresher Maws devour the Alliance colony of Akuz. What is a Thresher Maw? In retaliation, 2178, retaliation for Skillian Blitz, an Alliance fleet wipes out an army of slavers on the moon of Torfan. And 2183 is our current date. Okay, so we can move forward. Oh, I don't want to shoot that. How do I put that away? Talk?
You probably don't want to keep the captain waiting, Commander.
The captain's waiting for you in the comm room, Commander.
Righto.
I'm telling you, I just saw him. He marked pilot, he was on a mission.
He's a Spectre, they're always on a mission.
And we're getting dragged, right along with him.
Relax, Presley. You're gonna give yourself an ulcer.
Congratulations, Commander. Looks like we had a smooth run. You heading down to see the captain?
I heard you arguing.
Sounds like you don't trust our Turian guest.
Sorry, Commander. Just having a chat with Adams down in engineering. Didn't mean to cause any trouble. But you have to admit, something's odd about this mission. The whole crew feels it.
What do you mean?
You think the Alliance brass is holding out on us?
If all we're supposed to do is test out the stealth system, why is Captain Anderson in charge? And then there's Nihlus. Spectres are elite operatives, top covert agents. Why send a Spectre, a Turian Spectre, on a shakedown run? It doesn't add up.
Investigate? Yeah, about this Turian Spectre.
You don't trust Nihlus.
I don't like Turians in general. It runs in my family. My grandfather fought in the First Contact War. Lost a lot of friends when the Turians hit us.
It was long ago.
That was 30 years ago. You can't blame Nihlus for that.
No, I guess not. But But it still makes me nervous to have a Spectre on board, especially a Turian. We're an Alliance vessel, human military, but Nihlus doesn't answer to the captain like the rest of us. Spectres operate outside the normal chain of command, and they don't come along just to observe shakedown runs. Nihlus looks like he's expecting some heavy action. I don't like it.
What about the captain?
Do you have a problem with the captain?
No, ma'am. But I can't figure out what he's doing here. Captain Anderson is one of the most decorated special forces officers in the service. If he melted down all his medals, he could make a life-size statue of himself. You don't send a soldier like that on a do-nothing mission. He's treating this shakedown run too seriously. Something big is going on.
Okay, I get the general feeling that something big is going on, more than they're telling us. Stealth systems?
What do you know about the stealth systems?
I just know it masks our location from scans and sensors. Cutting-edge technology. The Normandy's the only ship with this prototype drive. But why are we fully staffed? A skeleton crew would be cheaper. Less chance of security leaks, too. Plus, there's Nihlus. It's pretty obvious this shakedown run is just a cover.
A cover?
For what?
Damned if I know, Commander. We're out here on false pretenses. I'm not a fan of being left in the dark.
I'll look into it.
I'll see if I can get some answers when I see him.
Good luck, Commander.
Okay, so I'm just going to read this really quick. Light lag prevents sensing in real time at great distances. A ship firing its thrusters at the Charon relay can be easily detected from Earth 5.75 light hours, 6 billion kilometers away, but Earth will only see the event 5 hours and 45 minutes after it occurs. Due to the light speed limit, defenders can't see enemies coming until they have already arrived. Because there is faster than light travel and communications, but no faster than light sensors, frigates are crucial for scouting and picket duties. Passive sensors are used for long-range detection, while active sensors obtain short-range, high-quality targeting data. Passive sensors include visual, thermographic, and radio detectors that watch and listen for objects in space. A powered ship emits a great deal of energy. The heat of the light support systems, the radiation given off by power plants and electrical equipment, the exhaust of the thrusters. Starships stand out plainly against the near-absolute zero background of space. Passive sensors can be used during faster-than-light travel, but incoming data is significantly distorted by the effects of the mass effect envelope and Doppler shift. Active sensors are radars and high-resolution LADARs, laser detection and ranging that emit a ping of energy and listen for return signals. LADARs have a narrower field of view than radar, but LADAR resolution allows images of detected objects to be assembled. Active sensors are useless when a ship is moving at FTL speeds. Just mark everything viewed. Maybe so that thing goes away. Okay.
I grew up on Eden Prime, Doc. It's not the kind of place Spectres visit. There's something Nihlus isn't telling us about this mission.
That's crazy. The captain's in charge here. He wouldn't take orders from a Spectre.
Not his choice, Doc. Spectres don't answer to anyone. They can do whatever they want. Kill anyone who gets in their way.
Oh, you watch too many spy vids, Jenkins.
That's Leroy Jenkins, is it?
What do you think, Commander? We won't be staying on Eden Prime too long, will we? I'm itching for some real action.
I sincerely hope you're kidding, Corporal. Your real action usually ends with me patching up crew members in the infirmary.
Relax, Jenkins.
You need to calm down, Corporal. A good soldier stays cool even under fire.
Sorry, Commander, but this waiting's killing me. I've never been on a mission like this before, not one with a Spectre on board.
Golly, we can investigate. Let's investigate. What do you think about Nihlus?
What can you tell me about Nihlus?
Arcturians are generally well respected by the other species. Their fleet has more patrols protecting Citadel space than any other. They don't always get on well with us, though. Some people find them too rigid. Others still blame them for the First Contact War. As for Nihlus, I haven't said more than two words to him. He usually only speaks to the captain.
I heard Nihlus once took down an entire enemy platoon all by himself. Man, I can't believe I'm on a mission with an actual Spectre.
Just give this guy a beanie hat and he'll do well. About the Spectres in general.
What do you know about the Spectres?
Only what I've heard. Spectre agents work directly for the Citadel Council. They usually work alone or in small groups. Spectres don't have any official power, though. Basically, they're a shadow organization with a mandate to preserve and protect galactic stability.
Protect it at any cost. Don't forget that part. Spectres operate above the law.
There are no human Spectres?
Why don't we have any of our own people in there?
Spectres usually come from the council races, like the Turians. We've been trying to get a human accepted into their ranks for years now. So far, it hasn't happened.
Hey, Commander, you'd make a good Spectre. You're a war hero, right? Held off an entire enemy fleet during the Blitz single-handed? That's the kind of talent the Spectres are looking for.
This is all just wild speculation. The Spectres aren't interested in recruiting humans, no matter how capable.
Well, can you two tell me about Eden Prime?
You're from Eden Prime, aren't you, Jenkins? What's it like?
It's very peaceful, Commander. They've been real careful with development, so you don't have any city noise or pollution. My parents lived on the outskirts of the colony. At night, I used to climb this big hill and stare across the fields back at the lights from the main settlement. It was gorgeous. But when I got older, I realized it was a little too calm and quiet for me. That's why I joined the Alliance. Even Paradise gets boring after a while.
Why are we going there?
Any idea why Eden Prime was chosen as our destination?
Not really sure, Commander. Eden Prime's one of our most stable colonies. Good place to take the Normandy for a shakedown run, I guess. No real danger there. There's gotta be something else going on. We've got a Spectre on board. That's why I'm so wound up. I can't wait for the real mission to start.
You'll do fine.
Just treat this like every other assignment you've had and everything will work out.
Easy for you to say. You proved yourself in the Blitz. Everybody knows what you can do. This is my big chance. I need to show the brass what I can do.
Don't play the hero.
This mission isn't about personal glory, Corporal. We have a job to do. Don't do anything stupid to mess it up.
Don't worry, ma'am. I'm not gonna screw this up.
See ya.
The captain's waiting for me.
Goodbye, Commander.
Guy's funny. Who that? I can't talk to you. You're not important. None of these people are important. Okay. Ugh. Wish we could have a first-person view. The man, or alien himself.
Commander Shepard, I was hoping you'd get here first. It will give us a chance to talk.
Where's Captain Anderson?
The captain said he'd meet me here.
He's on his way. I'm interested in this world we're going to, Eden Prime. I've heard it's quite beautiful.
What else if I clicked this? I wouldn't know.
I've never been there.
But you know of it. It's become something of a symbol for your people, hasn't it? Proof that humanity can not only establish colonies across the galaxy, but also protect them. But how safe is it, really?
What's your point?
If you've got something to say, just say it.
Your people are still newcomers, Shepard. The galaxy can be a very dangerous place. Is the Alliance truly ready for this?
I think it's about time we told the Commander what's really going on.
This mission is far more than a simple shakedown run.
Well, that's obvious.
I already figured that out.
We're making a covert pickup on Eden Prime. That's why we needed the stealth systems operational.
Why the secrecy?
There must be a reason you didn't tell me about this, sir.
This comes down from the top, Commander. Information strictly on a need-to-know basis. A research team on Eden Prime unearthed some kind of beacon during an excavation. It was Prothean.
Prothean?
I thought the Protheans vanished 50,000 years ago.
Their legacy still remains. The mass relays, the Citadel, our ship drives. It's all based on Prothean technology.
This is big, Shepard. The last time humanity made a discovery like this, it jumped our technology forward 200 years. But Eden Prime doesn't have the facilities to handle something like this. We need to bring the beacon back to the Citadel for proper study.
Obviously, this goes beyond mere human interests, Commander. This discovery could affect every species in Council space.
Why did we tell the Council?
Why didn't we keep the beacon for ourselves?
You humans don't have the best reputation. Some species see you as selfish, too unpredictable, too independent, even dangerous.
Sharing that beacon will improve relations with the Council. Plus, we need their scientific expertise. They know more about the Protheans than we do.
The beacon's not the only reason I'm here, Shepard.
Nihilus wants to see you in action, Commander. He's here to evaluate you.
Why?
What's going on, Captain?
The Alliance has been pushing for this for a long time. Humanity wants a larger role in shaping interstellar policy. We want more say with the Citadel Council. The Spectres represent the Council's power and authority. If they accept a human into their ranks, it shows how far the Alliance has come.
You held off an enemy assault during the Blitz single-handed.
People keep saying that.
Not only courage, but also incredible skill. That's why I put your name forward as a candidate for the Spectres.
I hate that nose. I hate that nose. Gonna have to get used to it, I suppose. Put my name forward?
Why would a Turian want a human in the Spectres?
Not all Turians resent humanity. Some of us see the potential of your species. We see what you have to offer to the rest of the galaxy, and to the Spectres. We are an elite group. It's rare to find an individual with the skills we seek. I don't care that you're human, Shepard. I only care that you can do the job.
You support this, Captain?
I assume this is good for the Alliance.
Earth needs this, Shepard. We're counting on you.
I need to see your skills for myself, Commander. Eden Prime will be the first of several missions together.
You'll be in charge of the ground team. Secure the beacon and get it onto the ship ASAP. Nihilus will accompany you to observe the mission.
Tell me about these Protheans.
What do you know about the Protheans?
Just what they taught us in school. They were a technologically advanced species that ruled the galaxy 50,000 years ago. Then they vanished. Nobody really knows how or why, though I've heard plenty of theories. But everyone agrees, galactic civilization wouldn't exist without them.
Their citadel is the very heart of galactic society, and without their mass relays, interstellar travel would be impossible. We all owe the Protheans a great debt.
What do we know about this beacon?
Why is this beacon so important?
All advanced galactic civilization is based on Prothean technology. Even yours.
If we hadn't discovered those Prothean ruins buried on Mars, we'd still be stuck on Earth. That was just a small data cache. Who knows what we can learn from this beacon? What if it's a weapons archive? We can't let it fall into the wrong hands.
Whose hands are the wrong hands?
Like who?
The Attican Traverse isn't the most stable sector of Citadel space. There are plenty of raiders and criminal groups active in the region. They might figure a Prothean beacon is worth the risk of attacking an Alliance ship. Plus, Eden Prime is right on the border of the Terminus systems.
Terminus systems?
The Attican Traverse is under Citadel protection. If the Terminus systems attack, it's an act of war.
Technically, yes. But some of the species in the Terminus might be willing to start a war over this.
The last thing the Council wants is to get dragged into a major conflict with the Terminus systems. We have to keep this low-key.
Tell me about Eden Prime.
I'd like to know more about Eden Prime before we touch down.
It's a peaceful farming world, but it represents something much bigger. Eden Prime is one of our oldest and most successful colonies. It proved we were ready to face the challenges of settling new worlds, to forge a place for humanity beyond Earth. It symbolizes humanity's growth and evolution as a spacefaring species. And after this, it will be known as the world where humans made a discovery of galactic importance.
Okay, so it's pretty important in that respect. I guess I'm ready to go.
Just give the word, Captain.
We should be getting close to Eden.
Captain, we got a problem.
What's wrong, Joker?
Transmission from Eden Prime, sir. You better see this.
Bring it up on screen.
Get down!
I repeat, heavy casualties! We can't... get evac! They came out of nowhere! We need...
It's the shadows.
Everything cuts out after that. No comm traffic at all. Just goes dead. There's nothing.
Reverse and hold at 38.5.
Looks like a shadow vessel. From Babylon 5.
Status report.
Kinda.
17 minutes out, Captain. No other Alliance ships in the area.
Take us in, Joker. Fast and quiet. This mission just got a lot more complicated.
A small strike team can move quickly without drawing attention. It's our best chance to secure the beacon.
Grab your gear and meet us in the cargo hold. Tell Alenko and Jenkins to suit up, Commander. You're going in.
Engaging stealth systems. Somebody was doing some serious digging here, Captain.
Digging?
Your team's the muscle in this operation, Commander. Go in heavy and head straight for the dig site.
What about survivors, Captain?
Helping survivors is a secondary objective. The beacon's your top priority.
Approaching drop point one.
Nihilus, you coming with us?
I move faster on my own.
Tech thousand now.
Nihilus will scout out ahead. He'll feed you status reports throughout the mission. Otherwise, I want radio silence.
You count on us.
We've got his back, Captain.
The mission's yours now, Shepard. Good luck!
We are approaching drop point two.
That's like the view of an ant. Like, aye!
Ship perimeter secure, Commander. Smells like smoke and death.
This place got hit hard, Commander. Hostiles everywhere.
Now...
The Terminus systems are located on the far side of the Attican Traverse, beyond the space administered by the Citadel Council or claimed by the Human Systems Alliance.
Okay, I'll listen.
It is populated by a loose affiliation of minor species. United only in their refusal to acknowledge the political authority of the Council or adhere to the Citadel Conventions. Their independence comes at a price. The Terminus is fraught with conflict. War among the various species is common, as governments and dictators constantly rise and fall. The region is a haven for illegal activities, particularly piracy and the slave trade. At least once a year, a fleet from the Terminus invades the nearby Attican Traverse. These attacks are typically small raids against poorly defended colonies. The Council rarely retaliates, as sending patrols into the Terminus systems could unify the disparate species against their common foe, triggering a long and costly war.
Okay, I know you guys want to see some action before we sign off. Second episode. So I'll look at the other two after. quick slots. Yeah. This is what I don't know about, guys. Alright, move forward. Now they're harmless, but... good for target practice, right? So the guy's going to automatically move forward with me now? This isn't anything. Is there a map? Left click on the map and drag the cursor to scroll. Well, there's a dig site, so we need to go all the way up there. Jenkins! Jenkins!
Rip right through his shields. We're out of chance.
We can't help him now.
Sometimes Marines die. The rest of us just have to carry on. We still have to find that beacon.
Aye, aye, ma'am.
Interesting to see at the end, you know. I'm just picking the choices that I like. Interested to see if it would be more Renegade or more Paragon. Move forward, page up, right? Am I headed the right way? I think. Wait, who is this? That's me. That's him. Okay. How do I get him to just automatically follow me? I'm pretty sure there's unlimited ammo in this game. Riot control. I'm crouched, right? Okay, I can't work like that. I know we're just getting into it here, but we're past the half-hour mark. Thanks for watching. See you next time, and endure. And enduring, grow strong.